Who first pioneered the anthropomorphic animal thing?
That's a good question, man.
Was it Steamboat Willie? Was that the first one?
No, it couldn't have been. Couldn't have been.
That's crazy. It was
Ephraim the retarded rabbit.
Like, who? Who thought of that? Like, I want to make an animal, but I want to make it a person, too.
What about, like, oh...
We were here before, right?
When was Watership Down?
Watership Down, written? I feel like it was written in the 50s.
Okay, what about Animal Farm?
I don't know what that is.
What?
I don't know what that is.
How do you not know Animal Farm?
Animal Farm.
Yeah.
That can mean so many things.
I think it was George Orwell? I'm probably wrong on that. But it's, I guess they're not anthropomorphic, though. They're just, like...
That was cool how that happened.
That's, like, Babe, I guess.
How old is Babe, even?
That was 90s, right?
I don't know.
Oh, man, he's super blocky. I'm gonna fucking do this shit to him. Fuck your legs.
Oh!
Is he dead?
Yeah.
Oh. Nice!
Just like, son of a bitch! He rocked his world.
Tight.
But it's crazy how, like...
Fuck that.
Bloater. It's crazy how prevalent anthropomorphic animals are.
Yeah.
Like, in everything.
Yeah, it's like a whole fucking industry now. Come on. Come on.
There you go. Pop another one of them. There you go. That's a good place to put it.
Shoot him in the taint.
He's gonna pop.
Yeah.
He's gonna pop. Watch out.
Yep.
Does it hurt you?
Probably.
We've never been close enough to know, yeah. But I feel like they would totally cunt you out like that.
Oh, yeah.
Is this guy gonna wake up now?
Hey. Yeah. Yeah. Not great, but yeah. Thanks, man. Okay.
That was a suspiciously right. close crate to the other crate. I was like, Lucas is here.
Fucking. Yeah, what happened to Lucas?
Who cares? Fuck him forever.
Fair enough. I'm on board with that.
It seems like they're going to throw him in, but I don't know why they would at this juncture, you know?
Should I heal?
I don't know. What's in the box?
What's in the box?
No, there's a box to your left.
Oh, wait, what?
Right there. Corrosive.
Oh. Oh, shit, man. Good fucking eye.
Yeah.
I would have walked right the fuck past that.
Glad you didn't.
Oh, ah, Jesus. Man, with the coins, are we ever going back? That looks like a fucking mini game.
It looks like a whole thing.
That I don't want to get into.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm going to Healy. Well, it just...
Auto-saved.
Yeah,
yeah, so, let's see what's beyond door number one first.
Dude. Or do we want to... That looks like progress.
Yeah.
This looks like side save room.
That's interesting how game design works. Like, where you can reckon... Yeah.
Yeah.
Another fucking corrosive door.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Please be an herb.
Yeah, yeah. Oh,
Flugel.
Flugen.
Oh, shit. So many bombs.
Wow. They are selling the bombs,
is there going to be, like, a wide open place with a shitload
wide
of them?
Wide open places.
Yeah, yeah.
Room to blow them zombies up. Oh, hey. If I can just...
Is she, like, the end in Metal Gear 3? That would have been cool.
That would have been great.
I need you to fuck off.
Yeah. Get out of there, Ethan.
I can't talk.
Time to
right
be a man.
I'm a little preoccupied.
Please leave a message.
Ethan, you're not here.
Ethan?
What the fuck?
Hey, shh. I know. I'm not going to hurt you.
What
hey,
the fuck?
I would have if I could have helped you. What do you mean? I'm no killer, son. Neither is Marguerite.
I don't have baby hands.
Nor my boy Lucas. Or even Zoe here.
This was after your arm was cut off.
Eveline. She did this. What the
hell?
This
is current.
Now, what did she do to you?
Oh, dude, this is like some weird, like, in the ether shit.
That's what she calls it. I found her near a busted out tank in the bayou. Nothing changed after that.
So she infects you and then she takes control?
No. Not exactly, son.
He seems nice.
She just...
Well, yeah. It's like a part of them
she forces away into
is still in
your soul.
The goo or whatever. Like their consciousness yeah. is still... That's fucking cool.
And sad.
You are connected yeah. to her, and you can't resist the urge to...
Jack off.
I have so much chafing.
You're a different person after that. Just like Mia. So Mia sent me that message because of Eveline. Listen, the girl just wants a family of her own.
But she's a freak! Freak!
She's the key. Alright? You find her, and you stop her.
You got it, man.
I love you, Jack.
Ethan. Free my family. Please.
See, that's noble. That's a noble purpose.
Yeah, man.
I like it.
I don't like that Zoe's just yeah, standing just looking in out the fucking window, corner.
Too bad you're all gooey.
Stay away from him. Why?
Yep. We did a switch. You. All right.
I can make him love me. Don't.
Can you yeah. wiggle? Can you Zoe, wiggle, wiggle?
Make him love me. Make me love her.
So what?
Let's play house. We're gonna play doctor. Remember?
You should have just lied to her and then stabbed her in the brain.
Yes. Always that.
Yep.
Every time.
Uh-oh.
He's just holding his breath that whole time.
What happened to her? Where'd she go?
She probably did her disappear-y shit again. Because, you know.
Mia, how?
There's no time.
Plot.
You have to get out of here and find her.
There she is.
Here, take this.
What? Wait, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Saving your life. You need to go. I won't be able to resist for much longer.
You resisted for like 2 hours.
Now go kill that little bitch.
No. You got it.
No. Mia!
Yeah, come on.
No! Yeah.
Give me all your stuff first.
Yeah, please tell me you have her stuff.
No.
Why did we collect it? Were we supposed to put it in the item box?
Okay, I don't know, man.
Where the fuck are you?
We don't even have our stuff from earlier.
Yeah, we have a deficit of stuff.
This is fucking... Nope.
Fuck off.
Whatever that is. Nope.
Oh, fuck this place. Fuck. Good. Fuck off, Taylor.
Good.
Jesus.
Just run away. Bye.
Sorry.
Wide open spaces.
I am so confused by the
room to
pacing
off
of what's going on. I hear a low, rumbly, gurgly growl sound.
Yeah, it sounds like a chopper.
Yeah, that makes sense. I was thinking, like, it sounded like a jaguar.
Oh, Jesus.
Like, that's the last thing we need. Wow! Fuck!
Oh, getting real slow. Getting slow, come on.
Oh. Are you going under?
Going under!
Shout out to Evanescence. Wow.
It's been a while.
Yeah. It's been a while!
Nope. Damn it, man.
Sorry. At least we can tell how hurt we are now. So if you get your ass fucked, then at least you'll know how hard it's getting fucked.
Abercrombie salt mine. South Dolby. Enhanced handgun ammo.
Wish
for
we
that
had a
gun,
gun
that you don't have. February 18th, 1892. There's a collapse in the Paris and mine. Tuan and Beckford are dead. What the fuck is Tuan? And Huxley will never walk on his own again. Old man Stan was right. The ground there is too unfucking stable. February 19th, 1892. The company's not going to send us any replacements. They want us to work double shifts instead.
Double
I can't
shits.
Wait to get the fuck out of this old country that's not for old men.
Bip bop bip doo.
Bip bop doo. And hello to you.
Would you like some of my shoe? I don't think you do.
Why do you smell like glue?
Me Nux News.
Are they waiting? Are they watching us from that helicopter?
Oh, wasn't that,
that
in
was
the
in
demo?
The demo.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure that's an umbrella logo on that hella macaque-suckler.
Yeah. Oh. I wonder if Umbrella's behind it all.
Alpha Hello. 1, this is Bravo 1. Do you read?
Barry?
Rebecca! Property revealed zero survivors. Repeat, zero survivors. We did find evidence of a skirmish. Evelyn? Negative. However, we did find several encrypted messages from the Baker's son, Lucas, to an unknown third party.
What?
You can probably guess who that was.
That's just great.
Interesting.
We've had reports using the abandoned mine south of the property. I'm gonna
Jesus
go have
Christ.
A look. Roger that. We'll meet you at those coordinates. If you encounter Evelyn, orders are shoot to kill. Repeat,
okay.
Shoot to kill.
Just let that happen.
Yeah, just hang out. Let the fucking...
Oh, here we go.
Oh.
Do we have to fight humans now?
Yeah, they're like, totally going to try and kill us.
Like Dead Rising?
Oh, man.
Yeah!
Yeah! Wait, have we? Or are they in here? Right. What do we got? That's steroids, I'm assuming.
Yep. That's where I already put coins, so you should put them in there.
What do we got here? Stabilizer. And then, what's back there?
That was a magnum.
Oh, it just transferred over?
Yeah.
Oh, well, fuck yeah.
I think you can get both of them.
Oh.
Rumble in the Bronx.
Oh, man.
Fire down below.
That was not good.
I like to refer to my bowel movements as Jackie Chan movies.
Or Steven Seagal movies.
Under Siege, Under Dark siege. Territory.
Give me it.
Fuck yeah, dude. We're going to be killing a lot of human beings. Mm. Wait, how many coins do you have now?
None. There's two left in here.
Okay.
Been a long time since the rock and roll. Been a long time. Cashmere State.
Yeah.
Guys, Led Zeppelin's fucking dope.
I don't know
as
what
hell.
It is about Cashmere because it's so long and so repetitive, but I love hearing it every time.
Yeah.
Like,
just
yeah.
That, whatever it is, that progression is just so epic.
Yeah.
It's just like, oh yeah, it just gets you pumped every time. You're just like, yeah. Ooh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, fuck me, Seymour.
Who the fuck is Seymour?
Oh, I promised him not to tell you.
Well, now you have to.
What the hell was that? Did you hear that?
Yeah, it was like a breathy little breathy cunt thing.
Breathy cunt thing. Whoa.
Oh, what's up?
That's a lot of biz. Is that movement?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
There's like fucking three of them.
Yeah.
One of them sees me.
The farther one.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh, hey, bud.
Oh, damn.
Hey, bud. Oh, hey, bud.
Lots.
Yeah.
I like how getting me as things didn't work logically like I thought it would.
Yeah, no, not at all.
Like, it would have made sense if it was in the other item box. Fucking wiggle wobble
motherfucker. Oh, man, he fucking juked me on that last one. He got me good.
Next time someone's shooting at me, I'm going to flop my head around like that.
Whoa. Oh, you fucker! Oh, whoa,
what
no.
He doesn't have any arms left.
Oh, he did a jumpy.
Tried to fuck you with his dick.
Yeah, he
Are
did.
Are these guys just going to keep coming?
I super hope not. But they might, so I'm just going to go. Yeah.
There's a box.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh, you don't have the knife equipped. Oh, cool. Another one.
Use it.
Oh, you should have waited till you were hurt more.
Oh, you're right. It does heal you, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Is he gone? Nope.
God damn it. Don't shoot it.
Oh. Fuck you.
Fuck you, man.
Oh, no, not you.
I know.
Oh, okay. I was like, no. No. Things were good. No, don't. You. Flugenheimen!
Transmission Flugen.
Transference.
Why is Jason Isaacs, like, always evil?
I don't know. Always
evil.
Yeah.
As soon as he showed up in that movie, I'm like, he's evil.
Yep.
Look at him. Look how evil he is.
Look how evil Malfoy is. Yep. Yeah. Have you seen the OA yet?
Yeah, I did. I saw it before you did.
Okay. What did we never really talked about it, I don't think, did we?
I think we did.
Really?
Like, there wasn't a lot to discuss, but
I mean, drunk?
I don't know. Like, we had very similar views, like it seemed pretentious of the writer to make herself the main character.
Yes. And, oh yes, we did. Okay, it's coming back.
We didn't
now.
Like
it was via text, yeah, that's why I don't remember.
We didn't like her character really. And the payoff didn't seem that great. Like, I get why that was the thing, but it's kind of weird that that was the thing that was all for.
Oh, shit, I almost left that.
There were parts that were interesting about it, but there wasn't enough to sell me on the whole thing.
To salvage it.
Yeah.
Really? Okay, so spoilers. We're going to get into spoilers, probably.
If you have Netflix and you should have watched it already, it takes, like, 8 episodes and then it's done.
Yeah. We watched it in, like, one night.
Yeah.
The interpretive dancing. Like,
yeah.
When that came in, I was like, okay, this is really fucking stupid, but I'm still willing to give it a chance. But then it became, like,
the crux of the
fucking
show.
Yeah. And I'm like, oh, no. No to this. Like,
that was, like,
really hard no.
That was,
me.
Like, when I heard people speaking in tongues the first time, because I didn't know that was a thing at all.
In religion.
Yeah. But when I went to convention with you guys, you were there, right?
It's possible.
You actually might not have been. Shane Herzberg was there, and he...
Oh, yeah, that was when I had, I was really sick. God damn it. What the...
Wow, you died.
Wow.
That hasn't happened in a while.
You died.
What were you saying?
You were saying. I was really sick. I missed that convention.
Oh, okay.
That was the one that, like, Megan and Autumn...
Terry,
and...
Tweak.
Yeah. Yep, I missed out on that one. We have a really weird past.
We do.
But
hold on a second.
We did a lot of church stuff
when
we were kids.
Not very religious people either. We did a lot of dirty stuff during the religious things.
Oh, that's nice of them. Like, right here.
Yeah, that's lovely. But I went to the convention just because... mostly because my friends went.
Right.
I know I'm a sinner. Yeah, you can acknowledge that.
That's, like, what it was for. That's
what those Lucas traps?
Yes.
So, we were in the middle of the sermon. It was a big, like, stadium full of religious people, and all of my friends fell asleep. And
yeah,
I was like,
right.
I was like, okay, whatever. I'll use this opportunity to try and learn more about religion. Maybe I'll learn something. Maybe it'll be interesting. And then, like, 10 minutes in, he just starts. He's this weird Freddie Mercury-looking guy. With, like, a big forehead and, a, like, a creeper mustache. But then he just starts going, la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. And I was like, this is weird. And then I look over.
Assalamu alaikum, shalashaska.
I look over to the right to, like, see another person to give him, like, a, are you seeing this shit? But then then they're going, la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. And then I look around, everyone except the friends were just chanting and making weird tongue noises, and I got really frightened.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Never once heard about it.
Oh,
nice fucking dodge, bro. Whoa. fuck. But yeah, our past was weird. You and I had both dated Megan before.
Yep, that was a thing.
And she liked me during that convention, but I was really bad at reading the signs of that.
Oh.
Like, she sat on my hand in the car, in the van, And I was like, oh, sorry. But apparently she did that on purpose, which is a weird way to come on to someone.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm going to sit on your hand. And I'm like, okay.
Huh.
It's like, uh-oh, she's going to think I was trying to goose her, but she wanted me to goose
she
her.
She wanted you to goose her.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really hard sometimes. Especially so, you were primarily raised by your mother.
Wolves. Yeah. Oh, yeah, my mom.
So, Sean and I have had this conversation too. So, like, of course we had father figures, if not our fathers, you know, in the picture to some degree throughout our lives and childhood. But for the most part, we had very maternal
upbringings.
And I think that affects, like, your overall,
where'd you come
from? The way that you handle relationships and women and shit in general.
I can see that.
Because I've always been way more like, I don't want to be an asshole.
Yeah.
And I don't want to, like, my biggest thing is, like, I don't want to come off rapey to women.
Well, like, I don't know what people do, like, I mean.
Well, I know, but I mean, it's always in the forefront of my mind, is the thing.
If, like, if you're too aggressive.
Yeah, I don't like being aggressive.
Then you'll come off.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's not my thing, because I'm, like, I've watched too many Lifetime movies as a kid or something.
So are you saying that all the girls that have been interested in you, like, approached you first?
No.
Oh.
But as far as, like, making the first move and stuff.
Yeah.
It's rarely me. It's rarely been me, if at all.
Yeah.
Oh, look, one fucking bullet for the Magnum.
Sweet. I was like that as far as being set up with somebody. I was like that for most of my dating life. Autumn, then Megan, then the chick from Expo You Don't Know.
What the fuck? Where are they coming from?
All of those circumstances, it was like, hey, so-and-so likes you. You should date them. And then I'm like, all right.
Okay.
Like, sweet. I didn't have to do shit. Oh, what does this remind me of?
Get the fuck out of there!
This reminds me of fucking Oblivion. There was like a... Oh, cool. Give me a minute. They're just spaced apart enough that it sucks.
Eat dicks! No! I said eat dicks! Not my dick, though! Get away!
Eat your own dicks!
Eat your own dicks! Come on into dicks.
Did he jump somehow?
Yep, he jumped.
God
damn
it. Execution,
bitch.
That was like way too much stuff.
All right, yeah, we're gonna pop a Healy there.
But, yeah, it's weird. I feel like girls are inherently better at it. Like,
yeah.
Approaching someone.
Yeah.
But it's the dudes that are expected to approach them. Which boggles
my
mind.
Anymore? I don't know anymore. Conventions are
like,
so, like...
It's a whole new thing now.
Yeah, man, 2017's fucking new frontier and shit. Like, nobody knows what the fuck is up anymore. Fucking...
I don't envy people now, as far as dating, but I feel like it'd also be easier in a way.
Yeah, well, here's the thing, is, like, if you're coming up...
Cronenberg.
In this... Coming up Cronenberg. Everything's coming up Cronenberg. If you're growing up in this time...
There's got to be something over there, right?
Oh,
that's a trap.
That fucker. Right?
Where are you going to look under the bridge? Yeah, there's a rope there.
Yeah. Thank you. So, I feel like each generation probably has that mind fuck, like, oh man, I can't even imagine trying to date in this climate. But, like, when we were kids, you know, the older adults were just like, fucking... AOL Instant Messenger. What? No,
yeah.
I can't fucking wrap my head around that shit. But obviously we navigated it just fine.
Yeah.
So.
You know how shitty it's going to be if none of the boxes explode when you shoot them? None of them have so far, have they?
Right, but.
There you go.
I knew it was coming.
I was
going
to be so mad.
Because they had the,
like,
fucking Lucas traps.
Yeah.
Lucas
is a little dickweed.
He's a fucking sack of shit, Kid Rock looking ass motherfucker.
There was something fun about.
Oh, this is nice. Like, immediately, just like, yes, relief, and oh god, yes.
this is the.
I'm just gonna spend the rest of the game here. You guys fucking go in, take care of that shit.
There was something nice about dating, though. Like, just the process of it. Like, knowing somebody, getting to know them. Courting them and stuff.
Like, as kids?
Yeah.
Or just dating in general?
I suppose probably as a teenager more so than, like, an adult.
Yeah, so I've obviously realized this before because I'm fucking in my late 20s now, but I never think about it, and then when I do, it fucks my head up. I haven't dated as an adult.
Yeah.
So that's got to be fucking terrifying.
You didn't do the whole process. Like, you've already been you've been with the yeah. same person for like a decade.
Sam and I are high school sweethearts, so yeah. as they say.
We should read these real quick.
I've been reading them to myself, and I was gonna let the audience,
I suppose,
read
the audience
them
can
if
read
they
them.
Wanted to pause and read them. Mia's her favorite and all, but she doesn't seem to care. She actually goes and visits her sometimes. She thinks Mia's her mommy. Like I said, your bioweapon is fucked up.
Your bioweapon's fucked up.
Your bioweapon's
fucked. Take it back.
Your bioweapon doesn't have Wi-Fi.
That skipped a year. Go back.
Yeah, it did.
Okay. So I was okay, yeah. Whole year.
Almost.
Pretty much.
Evelyn's family obsession is getting out of hand. She's making everyone kidnap more and more assholes off the street to add to her freak show of a family. Maybe she's my mustache itched. Maybe she's getting tired of Mia not coming around, but it's a pain in the ass for me because I gotta clean up the mess whenever someone new comes along.
God damn.
By the way, Evie's kind of sick or something. Her skin is getting all wrinkly and she's getting gray hairs. Is that supposed to happen? It's almost like she's getting old all of a sudden. I fucking called
Granny.
It. Fuck it. So the kid, that's why she's
Evelyn.
All disappearing. It's a
yeah,
fucking
it's
apparition.
A
yeah, it's a projection
yeah.
of herself.
But Mia, how long was Mia doing stuff with them?
She's obviously raging. She's aging rapidly.
No, I mean Mia.
Yeah, I'm saying, I thought you were going down the route of why hasn't Mia aged. I think Evelyn is
the granny.
Aging
yeah.
rapidly.
Yeah, but Mia, she's been picking... It said Mia has been picking up people off the road and stuff and bringing them there.
Oh, I thought she was talking about Evelyn.
I guess probably that'd make more sense. This report details the symptoms that appear when the bacterium that grows inside of the E-Series infects a human. Be sure to read this document thoroughly before dealing with E-Series weaponized assets, hereafter referred to as mold.
Okay.
Initial infection, the mold ingests nutrients from the subject's body to propagate itself and slowly takes over cells within the body. As a side effect of this, the infected subject gains remarkable regenerative abilities. During experiments, we removed arms and legs from test subjects and found that they were able to coapt the amputated limbs in a matter of minutes. Mid-stage infection. Once the mold reaches the brain, the subject's thoughts become in tune with those of the E-Series asset. The subject starts to hear things and experience hallucinations and soon comes under complete control of the E-Series asset. If this state continues, the host will lose all sense of ego. Complete infection. After every cell in the body has been taken over by the mold, the subject begins to lose their human form. Physical mutations differ from case to case, but all result in him or her acquiring incredible physical strength. Containing a subject at this stage would be extremely difficult.
Cool.
Checks out!
All of that makes a bunch of sense.
Whoa. That is that a looks wacky like a looking thing.
Bioweapon if I ever
yeah,
fucking saw
bio
one.
Bioweapon is fuck.
Necrotoxin.
We were right about the necrotoxin.
5 minutes after dose.
What was that sound? I don't like that.
Jump back. Fuck myself.
I wonder if somebody didn't pick up on that EV being the old lady. Like, maybe they just walked past that.
That would have sucked. I feel like something's going to happen in the end, and they're going to be, like, way confused if they... What, target acquired?
Oh, is that the fetus?
Oh, shit. What?
Yeah, it's the fetus.
Oh, good call.
What do you do to it?
Where's that thing? There it is.
Nice.
The Eveline sample.
Are you going to... Whoa.
I don't know what it's doing.
I don't like that that's happening. Ooh.
Oh, I got a thing. Oh.
Necrotoxin.
Tight. Tight. Got a stabber. Got a stabber. Got it.
Oh, God, this boss fight's
E, necrotoxin, destroys cells of any subject based on the E-series bioweapon model. Use only for disposal of E-series assets. The toxin must first be stimulated before use.
You gotta foreplay.
Jack it. Yeah. Just use the alphabet,
tickle the nips,
kids.
On the
yeah,
E-series asset.
Do this by placing a sample of an E-series cells into the necrotoxin container.
Put your dick in it and
put
rub it around a
little.
Dick
in it. Just swivel stick it around.
Stir it like
bunch
a martini.
Of cocoa. Unless you're James Bond, then you gotta
shake it.
This project was instigated in 2000 as one of the several concepts for the company's NexBaz.
Drop the
next generation experimental battlefield superiority. Man, they really tried hard with that one.
Yeah.
Initiative, working with technical assistance from HCF.
There's no abbreviation for what that
Heathcliff is? Heathcliff Catfuckers to develop a bioweapon for neutralizing combatants en masse with minimal direct contact. NexBaz was later folded. We are sitting a little far away. And all its assets diverted to this project. What makes this project markedly different from conventional weapons is its ability to turn enemy combatants into allies, converting hostile elements into willing servants.
Hmm.
Since this effectively eliminates the cost of not only POW handling, but also combat itself, it's no wonder we had the fuck and even fucks organization chomping at the bit to get on board.
Hmm.
Interesting. The project would never have existed were it not for the discovery in fucks of Umbrella, the remarkably progressed vicariant evolution fungus that we commonly term mutamycete.
What was Umbrella's blanket organization called?
Tricell.
Okay. Maybe? I don't think it's either of those, or Umbrella or Tricell.
That might be
too long.
Umbrella. No.
Why do they block that out?
No. Damn. The fabrication method for each bioweapon was to introduce the mutamycete. Fucking science. Pseudoscience words.
Mitochondria
drink.
Just call mitochondria.
Yep. Genome to pre-stage 4 human embryo and perform cultivation in a controlled environment over a period of 38 to 40 weeks. The resultant organisms were referred to as candidate specimens and graded based on usability from the impractical and faulty vaginas, series A through D, to the perfected E series. A common appearance was selected for the bioweapons, that of a roughly 10-year-old girl,
roughly,
of course, to ensure ease of blending in with urban refugee populations. No, it was so that you could make metal bands out of them if you needed to. Japan, I'm on to you. The E-series specimen named Eveline was proven capable of secreting the mitochondria fucks from her tissue at will. It is also of note that Eveline's mitochondria imposes a profound control over body and mind when introduced into a host organism. We still have a lot to learn about the mechanism in which Eveline achieves and maintains this control, but the working theory is that the vector man is similar to the auto-inducer pheromones used for quorum sensing in Pseudomonas bacteria.
Motherfuck.
Fucking science,
man. Oh, man, I dropped out of school.
Eveline's control is exerted in a series of discrete stages, the first of which is hallucination. Almost immediately after infection, the subject begins to see images of Eveline, though she is not, in fact, there, and even hear her voice, which is audible to anyone else.
Inaudible.
Yes. Auditions
for the voice.
For the voice were held in Los Angeles with infected subjects throughout the stages of infection. Reveal at that at first, the phantom. Jesus. Okay, hang on. The phantom Eveline appears to be a normal young girl, sometimes desiring companionship or assistance. As time progresses, she begins making more and more extreme demands, inducing self-mutilation and attacks on other people. The
Look
psychological
how long
shock
that fuck is.
this what? Induces helps to break down the provides natural barriers to Evelyn's brainwashing effect. And by the time mental control is achieved, the mitochondria infection has progressed throughout the body's cells, so the body fucks itself.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Is it multiple words? Like, do they account for spaces and shit, too?
Possibly.
God damn.
I want that drill. That drill looks really good. They did a blender. Really good job with that drill. I'm pretty sure my grandma had that fucking blender.
Yeah, it's even got the yellowing of age on it.
Yeah. Like, this is from the late 70s, early 80s.
God damn, that was a mouthful. They should have spread that out into multiple files somewhere.
Something. I look like a more... God. Jesus fuck. You know, it's 2017. You got a bunch of fucking cutscenes with other bullshit dialogue. Evelyn's functions also include the ability to form organisms from mitochondria, the fungal fuckaments. The term organisms is used loosely here. Strictly speaking, they are superorganisms formed of countless mitochondria. What's important, though, is that they exhibit a strong survival instinct and will defend themselves ferociously with the slightest provocation. Their fungal toughness is and remarkable strength give them significant battlefield potential. The researchers have been calling these superorganisms the molded, made of mold, and also molded, as in shaped. The name has a certain elegance to it.
Yeah, no, sure.
Maybe in Japanese, but that was a fucking third grade sentence right there. For the treatment of accidental infections, performing fucks on samples of Evelyn's body tissue produces a unique fungicidal serum.
Fungicidal. Fungicidal.
There's a fungicidal maniac on the loose. Do not go to the mall. He's on the loose at your fucking pack, son. He's a fungicidal maniac. Administering the serum to an infected subject will cause the mitochondria to calcify, but if the subject's cells are already largely invaded, the serum will be fatal. Since the treatment window is so small, the serum's primary use is therefore disposal of infected subjects rather than a cure. In exploring the serum's potential, we found that subjecting it to fucks would enhance its effects to extreme potency, becoming a compound we now call E. necrotoxin, which fuck-a-lock-a-ding-dong is even tiny amounts. What's been interesting to observe in Evelyn's behavior is her obsession with the concept of fuckery. In experiments, we found on multiple occasions that the infected subjects were compelled to act as her mother or father, treating her as if she were really their daughter. Why did she settle upon family as the theme for her mental control?
What a creep.
What size of a dick does it take to please Pamela Anderson?
We'll never know. This is
just speculation, but it could be that she instinctively understands that a family unit is better suited to blending into social groups than a lone girl. On the other hand, well, a sentimental sort might suggest that she's making up for a perceived lack of love in her quarantine upbringing, a parent's love.
Maybe. Jesus.
Maybe she's a fucking sociopath.
Now that we have all the exposition ever in the game at all.
Flame rounds!
Oh man, Granny's gonna be a bitch.
Uh-huh.
Or just Lucas.
Flying around in her wheelchair.
I don't want to fight that.
Yeah, you're gonna.
That was so much reading.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that, like...
It was like 80% of my episode.
This is totally, like... way more than you would expect for, like, a first-person game to have.
Well, a fucking game in 2017. Like I said before, like, I don't care. Whatever, reading's cool, but Jesus, that was a fuck.
We also tape cassette reading. Players. Like,
yeah.
Why not do, like, a Bioshock audio tape thing where they just explain it while you move around?
Did they just not want to pay
voice actors?
I mean, clearly, you heard Zoe's accent, right?
And that is Mia, right? The same voice actress? It sounds like it. She's just slightly doing a different voice.
Oh, maybe. I don't know. Didn't even think of it.
Get out alive.
You want to get out alive, don't you? Alive.
All right, so that was that whole episode.
I guess. Yeah, that was the thing, right?
Yeah, we made progress. We know who Eveline is for sure now.
Yep.
I'm pretty sure one of us did call that.
Yes.
Like, way early on.
I believe so.
It might have been Lindsay. But, Billy thinks it's him. Let us know in the comments who you think it is. and tune in next time for when I get fucked around by something.
Well, I think it was that burning bush.
Mitochondria.
He done told me things. Drink.